mention is completed. Next topic is excretion. Now, in transportation, the whole raw materials are reached to energy is reached to the all the organs in our body with the help of the blood vessels, with the help of pumping of the heart and everything. Now, next is excretion. Excretion means the removal of the unwanted material from our body. Biological process involved in removal of harmful metabolic waste. Okay, we are eating food, we are having proteins, we are converted into amino acids, we are converted the carbohydrates into glucose, we are converted the fats into fatty acids and glycerol. From all these things, some kind of harmful metabolic products are also produced. Now, that product is to be removed from our body, otherwise it will be harmful to our body. Now, this process is known as excretion. That is, removal of the harmful metabolic substances from our body is known as excretion. Now, substances that are to be excreted are CO2, nitrogenous waste, excess of salt, water, and the fine pigments. CO2 is removed with the help of lungs only. We are exhaling out oxygen, we are inhaling oxygen, we are exhaling CO2. The CO2 is a byproduct hai jo hamare body mein se aise nikal jata hai, lungs hi nikal dete. Next is the nitrogenous waste. The nitrogenous waste include urea, uric acid, ammonia. This is removed out with the help of the excretion process, that is with the help of an organ known as kidney. Kidney is helpful in the excretion process. Next is excess amount of salt. The salt is removed with the help of excretion process, and some amount of salt is removed from our body in the form of sweat also. हमको पसीना आता है इन उस फॉर्म में भी हमारे बॉडी के जो सॉल्ट है इट इज रिमूव्ड आउट वाटर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ यूरिन एंड ऑल द प्रोसेस इज कैरीड आउट बाय द किडनी ओनली. नेक्स्ट इज द बाइल पिगमेंट्स. बाइल पिगमेंट्स आर फॉर्म यू नो दैट द आरबीसी रेड ब्लड सेल्स कैन ओनली लीव फॉर 120 डेज. सो आफ्टर 120 डेज दे डीनेचर, दैट इज दे आर डेड आफ्टर 120 डेज. सो आफ्टर दे आर डेड their components will be inside the blood only. So, it also should be removed from our body. So, that is the bile salts. Now, what happens in the bile pigments? Bile pigments are formed into the RBC. They go to the liver for destruction. The hemoglobin distributed, hemoglobin is destructed, and whatever components is remaining, it is removed out of the body. The nitrogenous waste include proteins, that is amino acids. Some amino acids left move to the liver and it forms urea. Okay, some amount of proteins are in the digestive process. We learned that the proteins are converted into amino acid. But what happens if it is not converted? Some amount of protein will be not converted to amino acid. So that proteins, amino acids will move towards the liver. In the liver, it will form urea. Liver mein kya ban jayega? Urea ban jayega. So, when the urea is not excreted from our body, the urea deposits. Urea khud ba khud ikhatta hoke lungs-like structure bana deta hai. That lung-like structure is known as stone. You would have heard of kidney stones, hai na? Stones gallbladder mein hota hai, liver mein hota hai, pancreas mein hota hai, stomach mein hota hai, kidney mein hota hai. So, wo stone jo hota hai, that is the composition, the deposition of urea inside a specific region. Bilirubin, that is converted of conversion of the bile pigments, it converts into bilirubin. So of the urine that we are passing out of our body, it is a greenish yellowish color. That yellowish color is because of the presence of bilirubin. Next is RBC is liver for regeneration and destruction that we have already discussed. Now the main topic in excretion is who does the excretion. The excretion is carried out with the help of kidney. Kidney is a bean shape. A bean shaped hota hai. It is a bean shaped structure. These are the two kidneys. Same way as I told you in structure of heart, this is the right side and this is the left side. So this is the right kidney, this is the left kidney. Right kidney is somewhat up and left kidney is somewhat down because of the stomach over here. Now, as soon as this is a renal artery means the blood with water and with the nitrogenous waste, with the bilirubin, everything comes inside, is brought by the renal artery. The purified blood is brought by the renal artery. It comes with the help of renal artery. It enters into the kidneys, that is the left kidney and the right kidney, from the left kidney and right kidney. Inside the left kidney and right kidney, there are structures known as nephrons. Okay, जैसे हमारे बॉडी में सेल्स होते हैं उसी तरह हमारे बॉडी में नर्व सेल्स होते हैं. नर्व इम्पल्स के लिए बिलियंस ऑफ नर्व टिश्यूज नर्व सेल्स होते हैं. सेम वे इट हैज नेफ्रॉन्स, किडनी में क्या होते हैं नेफ्रॉन्स होते हैं ऑलमोस्ट 1.2 मिलियन नेफ्रॉन्स आर प्रेजेंट इनसाइड द किडनीज. सो नाउ द नेफ्रॉन्स डू द प्यूरिफिकेशन प्रोसेस दैट वी विल लर्न फर्दर हाउ डू दे डू द प्यूरिफिकेशन प्रोसेस. After they purify it, the unwanted kidney material, that is the nitrogenous waste and unwanted material, is taken to the ureter. The ureter passes urine to the urinary tract. This is just the tract which is helpful to carry the urine from the kidney. From urine, it is the urine is transported to the ureter. From ureter to the urinary bladder. This is a bag-like structure that stores the urine, and when it relaxes or contracts, the urine is passed out of her body with the help of urethra. Urethra is the opening that helps in passage of the urine. In the urethra, you have a sphincter muscles. This is S-P-I-N-T-C-H-E-R. C-H is silent here. It is known as sphincter muscles. The sphincter muscles contract and relax, and when it is filled up with the urine, it will contract and the urine will be passed out of her body. And when it relaxes, then again the urine will come out from the kidneys to the urinary bladder. Now we will study the structure of nephrons. This is the structure of nephron. In the structure of nephron, you have to basically learn about this 8 parts. First is the afferent arteriole. Afferent arteriole means the, this is the first one, afferent arteriole. I have labeled here 1, 2, 3, 4 so that it will be easier for you. Efferent arteriole means whatever the blood content is there with the nitrogenous waste, bilirubin, everything comes from here. It enters into the nephron's first structure, that is the third part, glomerules. This is glomerules. Glomerules mein aate hain. This is the afferent. Afferent matlab jisme se wapas jo bhi yahan pe some substances, proteins, amino acids, jo wanted proteins, amino acids, they also come with this urine inside the nephron. So what happens? They again absorb it, and they again, the purified blood is again taken to the other organs with the help of this efferent arteriole. So from efferent arteriole, it reaches to the glomerules. From glomerules, it passes to the, it has a capsule-like structure. This capsule-like structure is known as a Bowman's capsule. From the Bowman's capsule, the material is, the solution is passed through the proximal convoluted tubule. This is a proximal convoluted tubule. It is coil-like structure. From here, the filtration starts. From here, it is moved towards a downside region. There is a loop-like structure. This loop is known as a loop of Henle. From this loop, whatever the water material or the wanted material is, amino acid, salt, the wanted salt are all absorbed over here, and it will absorb it and it will again take it to the afferent arteriole. From the afferent arteriole, it will be again moved back to the organs. This is a descending loop, and it is permeable to water. And this is the ascending loop. Matlab this is यहाँ से नीचे आता है, and this is an ascending loop. Matlab यहाँ से नीचे से ऊपर जाता है. Again comes the distal convoluted tubule. From distal convoluted tubule, it reaches to the collecting duct. This is a collecting duct. ना collecting duct होता है nephrons में. ऐसे millions of nephrons, 1.2 millions of nephrons are present inside our kidney. From the collecting duct, it is moved to the urinary bladder. Here only you have urine. Only urine will be available in the collecting duct. Whatever the wanted things are there, whatever the salt, bilirubin or anything is inside this urine, and whatever the wanted materials, potassium and phosphorus, which we wanted, जो चाहिए होते हैं अमीनो एसिड्स हैं, अगेन इट इज टेकन, इट इज एब्जॉर्ब फ्रॉम डिफरेंट ऑर्गन्स. यहाँ पे जो डिस्टल कॉन्वर्टेड ट्यूबुल होते हैं, हेनलीज लूप होते हैं, इट ऑल एब्जॉर्ब द न्यूट्रिएंट्स जो गलती से इधर आ गए होते हैं, उनको एब्जॉर्ब कर लेता और वापस एफरेंट आर्टेरियल के थ्रू वो डिफरेंट ऑर्गन्स में पहुंचा देते हैं. एंड नेक्स्ट इज जस्ट अ डिटेल डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ इट. स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ग्लोमेरुल्स, इट इज अ नेटवर्क ऑफ कैपिलरीज that help to increase surface area. जैसे विलाई होता है surface area के लिए, वैसे ही यहाँ पे glomerulus में भी surface area बढ़ाने के लिए ही under coil like capillary structures होते हैं, and it is known as a malpighian capsule like structure होता है, इसलिए उसको malpighian capsule बोलते हैं. From the glomerule, the filtrate will be moved towards the next region, that is forward region. In the coil number 5 and 6, the parts would be labeled as 5 and 7, that is the convoluted tubules जो होते हैं, proximal convoluted tubule होते हैं, and the distal convoluted tubule, the coil structure help in increasing the surface area. Reabsorb certain nutrients needed to the body, and they reabsorb the nutrients. distal conduited tubule helps to reabsorb salt, potassium and sodium, and it is known as osmoregulation. Next is important that substances should not be removed in this filtrate. So glucose, H2O, minerals, potassium, sodium has to be reabsorbed in these three steps. The reabsorption takes place in these three steps inside this nephron only. Nephron ही ये reabsorption का काम करता है. First जो होता है वो malpighian body में, जो malpighian capsule में होता है वहीं पे हो जाता है. That is ultrafiltration. That is the first part of nephron. Second reabsorption होता है selective reabsorption. That is transport of glucose और amino acids जो गलती से आ गए होते हैं उनको reabsorb कर लेता है. That is selective reabsorption. Then the third is tubular secretion. जो tubular conjugated tubules और proximal distal tubules होते हैं वो last part होता है. वो क्या करते हैं, वो बाकी के secretions कर लेते हैं. अब excretion हो गया humans का. Now same way excretion in plants भी, plants भी excrete करते हैं. प्लांट्स को भी ऑक्सीजन, ड्राई ऑक्सीजन जो एक्सक्रीट करते हैं, दे एक्सक्रीटेड विद द हेल्प, ऑक्सीजन इज एक्सक्रीटेड विद द हेल्प ऑफ एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेस. टोमेटा हेल्प करता है ट्रांसपिरेशन में, वाटर रिमूव हो जाता है उनके बॉडी में से. फिर यू कैन सी द ड्राई लीव्स. ड्राई लीव्स कैसे होते हैं, वो उनके बॉडी में से तो ऐसे ही गिर जाता है, दे फॉल फ्रॉम द बॉडी. यू वुड हैव सीन गम्स. गम्स क्या होते हैं, वो भी अनवांटेड मटीरियल होते हैं, उनके जो मिनरल्स होते हैं वो एक्सक्रीट आउट करने का एक वे होता है गम्स, रेजिन्स एंड एवरीथिंग. Next is water loss that we have already discussed because of transpiration. So here we complete the chapter number 6. So if any doubts you are having, you can note it down in your notebook, and as soon as the school is resumed back and we will rejoin the school, we can discuss about all the doubts. Thank you.